Good afternoon. One final issue that we have as it pertains to Kiddush on Friday night or Shabbos day is that after we've made Kiddush and we've washed and been eating the meal, if we want to go ahead and drink wine again, doesn't need another bracha. Now, certainly it does not need a new bracha of Borei Pri Hagafen, presuming that it was at least in the vicinity of the meal. Then it would, though, need another bracha, perhaps, of the bracha of the Hatov the Hametiv, that the one who is good and does good. The Shulchan Aruch rules that if one is drinking wine and then a better wine is brought to the table, even though it does not require a new Borei Pri Hagafen, it would require this bracha of Hatov the Hametiv. However, there are many details that qualify when one would indeed recite this bracha. There are so many details, in fact, that some, including the Minchas Yitzchak, go as far as saying that it is extraordinarily rare that we would recite the bracha. And because of all of these qualifications, we would usually apply the rule of Safek Brachos Lehakel, of any doubt of a bracha, that we should be lenient. And therefore, in almost all cases, we would not actually recite the bracha. Rav Mordechai Eliyahu suggests that the minhag among Sfardim is that we would still recite the bracha today, only under the circumstances that we are eating together with a major Talmud Chacham who knows and is familiar with all of the details and can instruct accordingly that we should recite the bracha. But short of that, also one would not recite the bracha. Because of this debate, some have adopted the practice of acting in such a way that would avoid the questions entirely, such as being sure to first use the better bottle of wine, and therefore there would never be an issue of having a secondary, a preferred bottle of wine afterwards, or at least having both on the table simultaneously so that we know and we would not require bracha in that case. But if one does not avoid the situation, then they should try their best to think ahead of time and clarify with a Talmud Chacham, with their Rav, with a Posek, whether that circumstance would require a bracha of Hatov v'Hametiv to be said or not. If one finds himself at the table, having not asked and being in a situation of doubt, then as the Minchas Yitzchak points out, we would always follow the rule of Safek Brachos Lehakel, that if we have any doubt, we would be lenient. This, of course, does not apply in a case where one has a particular practice and has a particular Rav and Posek to be following that they understand the qualifications, and they determine with clarity that this is a situation which would require the bracha of Hatov v'Hametiv. In such a circumstance, one should, in fact, recite the bracha Hatov v'Hametiv. But again, short of that, we would tend to follow this practice of the Minchas Yitzchak. One final note is that if one is in a situation where they are not comfortable reciting the bracha Hatov v'Hametiv, either out of doubt or because they hold that definitively this is not an appropriate situation to recite the bracha, certainly they can and should have in mind, even if not verbalized, the tremendous hakaras hatov, appreciation to God for providing these and all other delicacies, as well as all of the good he provides us with. Have a fantastic day.